Recording.
Okay, so last time we started a new chapter about representation category of OpFalgebra, and in fact, the goal of this chapter is to show the correspondence between ring category or tensor category and bialgebra or OpFalgebra. In fact, we will show that a ring category is more or less exactly the same thing as, so a ring category with some fiber functor is the same thing as a bialgebra. And a tensor category with a fiber functor is equivalent to the data of an OpFalgebra. So this is a representation of OpFalgebra. Representation of OpFalgebra is the tensor category with a fiber functor, and the converse is true in some sense. We will explain in this chapter. So last time we defined the notion of fiber functor, quasi fiber functor. And we provided some examples coming from group theory. And we also provided an example going from topology to justify the name fiber. So today we will talk about bialgebra. So we will provide the notion of a structure of bialgebra on the algebra of natural transformation between the fiber functor and itself. So today we will explain the structure of bialgebra on and F with F aussi avec fiber functor. Where C is a ring category. So I will explain later what is this set. But before that, we need to recall the notion of Deligne tensor product of category and of functor. So before, for so, we need to recall the notion of Deligne tensor product of locally finite abelian category, the tensor product category and functor. Okay. So what this is about, the Deligne tensor product. So let C D be two locally finite abelian category. Abelian category. And we assume also K linear The deux lignes tensor product so denoted like that si D with a square and a cross inside the square is a finite so no not finite so is an abelian category K-linear define by the following universal property. As for any notion of tensor product, it's always often defined as using universal property. For example, tensor product of vector space. So the universal property is the following. So there is a B functor like that from C cross D to C so X. Y. So which is right exact the bifunctor right exact in both variables such that for any other such bifunctor, for any other such bifunctor, it's always like that in some universal property. You define something such that for any other thing like that, you have a morphism. So for any other such bifunctor, F from C cross D to A. To any K linear abelian category. Et, so there is a unique, so I need more space. I will draw a picture then. This is always the same ID for universal properties. So there is a unique right exact functor F bar from C B A such that F bar composed with that is F itself. So diagram. So you define this map. such that for any, so this map is right exact bifunctor, and it is defined in such a way that for any other right exact bifunctor from C cross D to some k-linear abelian category, for any such, there always exists a functor f bar such that this diagram commutes. So, so this is a universal property. Universal property. Okay. So we started from locally finite abelian category, and it is defined the six. So C, so this Deligne product, tensor product, is defined to be just a abelian category, but in fact, it is locally finite also. So that can be proved. So I will not prove that, but I just mentioned the statement to exist. So it always exists. So when you define something by universal property, it does not always exist in general, a priori, but here it exists. And is unique up to a unique equivalence and is locally finite. So I guess this is due to Deligne. And in fact, we said that the bifunctor is defined as being right exact, but in fact, I guess Deligne also proved that it's in fact also left exact. So it's bi-exact. It's bi-exact. And we have this natural isomorphism x1, y1 tensor on C x2, y2 is naturally isomorphic to si product x1, x2, y1, y2. So as I said, I will not go into the details for that. But for the proof, you see the book. See the book proposition 1.11.2 and its proof. Proof of that. So that's what I wanted to say for the Deligne tensor product of two categories. But we will, in fact, we will need Deligne tensor product for functor. Okay, so now the tensor product for two functors. And then we will use that to define a structure of bi-algebra on the set of natural transformation between the Fiber functor and itself. So Deligne tensor product of functor. Okay. So you take two functors. two right exact functors between locally finite abelian k-linear category. So let so f between c and c prime, g between d and d prime, right exact functor between locally finite abelian k-linear category. Okay. So we want to define the Deligne tensor product V G. So then define the functor F cross G from this Deligne tensor product to this one. So you will define that using the universal property defining the Deligne tensor product of category using the universal property defining si Deligne tensor product with so in other words, consider so you consider so you start from C cross D. You apply F cross G, you go to C prime cross D prime, and then you apply the B functor Deligne tensor product to go to C prime cross Deligne tensor product D prime. But we have the universal property. So universal as follow. So you have C so you have C cross D to C Deligne tensor product D. This is Deligne tensor product. But we also use the previous composition to C prime tensor Deligne tensor product D prime. So you can call that, this is what we called before F and A. F and A. Here it's so you have this composition F cross G. So this is what we call F before and what you call A before. So by definition of the universe, by definition, is defined. So you have what we call F bar, but here what we will call F compose F cross G bar. And so the Deligne tensor product of the two functors in other words, the Deligne tensor product defined as like that, the one given by the universal property. Okay. So that's all about the Deligne tensor product. So we can come back to ring category and by algebra. So let now we can come back to ring category and by algebra. So let C be a finite ring category. F from C to VEC, the fiber from term. With tensor structure G, so given by GX, so FX tensor FY to FX tensor Y. Okay. So, so the set or the space, anyway, the set of natural transformation from the fiber functor F to itself, so denoted and F, has an algebra structure. You can provide a structure of algebra on that, and then also of coalgebra, unital coalgebra. So we will see that. So first, so algebra structure. So an element is given by as follow. So so it's given by the following commuting diagram. So it's given by a series of morphism phi x such that you have the usual commuting diagram. I will write, because we will need it to see why there is an algebra structure. So here it's a natural transformation between F and itself. So you have F everywhere in the commuting diagram, FY, Y, FY, and you so take for all X, Y in C, and for all morphism between X and Y, like that. So F of F, F of F, and it commutes, which means that F of F composed with phi x is equal to phi y composed with F of F. Okay, so now, what about the algebra structure on such object? In fact, F is a fiber functor. So it's a functor from C to the category vec of vector space. And so the phi x, so a morphism between two objects in a vector, in the category of vector space, a morphism between two vector spaces is a linear map, it's a matrix if you want. So phi x is in the endomorphism between f of x and itself, but f of x, but fx is a vector space. So phi x is just a linear map. Or a matrix, if you prefer. If you prefer the matrix. So to get a matrix from a linear map, you need to fix a basis. You can think it as a matrix, up to a choice of a basis. Okay, so it's just a matrix, just a table of a number of scalar. Okay, so but you can. You can multiply, you can multiply an addition matrix. So the algebra structure on the matrix algebra and fx induce an algebra structure on end of f, induce an algebra structure on end f. So you have so f plus f prime is given by the series of morphism fx phi x plus f phi x prime. The multiplication or composition, if you prefer, is given by the composition also, like that. Now, the problem is to show warning. We need to show that the commuting diagram shows the commuting diagram for f plus f prime and f f prime as defined above. We need to show that satisfies the commuting diagram also. We know that satisfies, and that satisfies, but we need to check that also the addition satisfies. So well, it's not complicated. So I also have that, but I will not, because it should be an algebra. So lambda f is given by lambda phi of x. That's okay. So the two first, how to check the commuting diagram. So we need to check. We want to check that. So you can just write Sauf F. F of F compose with phi x plus phi x prime, phi prime x. So you develop, so it's F of F compose with phi x plus F of F compose with phi prime x. And it's equal to, now we can apply the Compton diagram. So it's equal to phi y compose F of F plus phi prime y compose F of F. So it is phi y. So it's trivial. Compose with F of F. Okay. And the other one, you start F of F composed with phi x composed with phi prime x. So the composition here is just product of matrix. Here it's addition of matrix as a written. This is what I wanted to state here. So it works also similarly. So you have F of F. So the composition is associative. Compose with F of X, compose with prime of X, which is here it's associativity. Associativity. And then you apply the commuting diagram. So you have phi of Y compose F of compose with, and again you apply associativity. And phi y compose phi f compose. Apply associativity, so I will not draw, will not write. So you have a phi prime. So it's associative. In fact, you don't need to write the parentheses anyway. Composed with f. And it's okay. This is what we wanted to prove. Phi y. It's straightforward. Anyway. This one. Okay. So it's okay. So we can add and multiply. Like that. So maybe I made. Something wrong. So there is something wrong here. So I did not take my pen. What time is it? The notation is not good. I should not say F or F prime, but so wait. So sorry about that. Of course, it's not F but phi. Should put phi you addition and compose two elements of and of F, so it's not F. Phi compose phi like that. That's better. Sorry about that. So phi plus phi prime, phi compose with phi prime is defined as okay. 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 That's okay. So, you take two elements of end of F, phi and phi prime, and you can add or multiply them by adding or multiplying the matrix corresponding. Okay, and as I said, here we check that the commuting diagram, the diagram commute. So it's well defined. Okay. So you have this has an algebra structure. So now we want to make it a co-algebra structure. So we need a co-multiplication and a co-unit. And we will define that using the Deligne tensor product we mentioned just before. So how? Okay. So Deligne tensor product. Will be used to provide a co-multiplication delta from H to H tensor H with H, the algebra we mentioned just before. Algebra of natural transformation between the fiber functor F and itself. And we will also define co-unit H to the field. Okay. So so let alpha. So consider some natural isomorphism alpha between and F tensor and F. So and F is an algebra. And of F Deligne tensor product F. So maybe prove the so this I guess that it come from universal property. I leave it as an exercise to show that you have such isomorphism. Okay, so as I said, where F, Deligne tensor product F, is Deligne tensor product Off font. So it is the functor between the product of C with itself to PEC. It's OK. So 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 we have this isomorphism alpha. So next. So we will use this alpha to define the multiplication. So let A an element of H. So you define so A tilde A in and of S F de l'intensor product with F defined by as follow. So it's also a natural transformation. So it is defined. Here you have two variables now, like that. So you will use the natural transformation A and the tensor structure like that. X, Y, J, X, Y. So you see, this is so you have you start from so let me write this let me put this on the left to get more space so you have so you start from F X tensor F of Y. You apply the tensor structure. You go to F X tensor Y. You apply the natural transformation A on X tensor Y. And you are still in F X tensor Y. And then you apply the inverse of the tensor structure. And you have F tensor Y. So this is exactly this map. The composition of that button. And it defines a natural transformation between this functor in itself. So you may need maybe to write some details to have a better understanding of what it is about here. And so we almost have what we want. The co-multiplication from H to H tensor H. We have something from H to that, so we need to come back. So we need to apply alpha inverse. So the co-multiplication is this as alpha tilde, and then you apply alpha inverse. So it's a delta tilde, and you apply alpha inverse. So is like that. So delta of A is defined as alpha inverse of delta tilde of A, of the natural transformation delta tilde of A. And now it is in and of F tensor and of F. So is a co-multiplication. Multiplication of on of and of F. What I need. Oh. So I will shift a bit the pause. Let me finish to write. I will shift the pause by 5 minutes. It's okay. Does not matter. And so we have the co-multiplication. So, and the co-unit is defined by the co-unit. So it's a map from the map from H to the field is defined. So you take the natural transformation A and you consider it, the A. So you take the series of morphism and you take the one corresponding to the object one. And it can be seen as an element of the field because so you have A is in and of F, A of X, F of X to F of X, A of one from F one to F one. But F1 is the field, it is a field. So it's an element from the morphism from the field to the field. So can be seen as a multiplication morphism on the field, given by element of the field also. So it's okay. Okay, so I will take the pause now. Pause. Sorry, I shifted the pause. And okay, so we define the co-multiplication and co-unit on this algebra of natural transformation between the fiber functor and itself using the Deuillean tensor product. Now, the result is that this co-multiplication and co-unit make this algebra the structure of co-algebra. So that should be proved. So I will not go into too much details because In fact, in this chapter, I will not go into too much detail because I want to focus on tensor category and this representation category of algebra. It's, yeah, it's a bit, it's not out of the subject, but it's a bit not exactly what I want to do. So, but it's very good to mention. So let H in be this algebra of natural transformation between the Fourier functor F. Then the algebra H is a co-algebra with co-multiplication delta and co-unit epsilon. And co-unit epsilon. Okay. And next, second point is so this map delta and epsilon are unital algebra homomorphism. The maps delta and epsilon are unital algebra homomorphism. I will not go into too much details about the proof, but I will mention some facts. So the proof, in fact, is follow more or less by definition. When I say more or less, you still have just something to check. For example, I will not write all the details, but for example, the co-associativity. We need so you can refer to the book on page 12 for the definition of what is a coalgebra, but the co-multiplication should be co-associative. The co-associativity of delta follow directly from the monoidal structure axiom. Monoidal structure axiom of the tensor structure J. So it's immediate. And for example, also the homomorphism delta is homomorphism because in other words, delta AB equal delta A. It's not well written. Delta AB equal delta A. Because you have as follow. Delta tilde A X and Y. Delta tilde B X Y is equal to G inverse X Y A X tensor Y G X Y. G X Y inverse B, x tenseur y, j, x, y. So you can simplify this one and this one. And you get that it is equal to j, x, y inverse of A x tensor y, B x tensor y, G x y, which is exactly. Okay. What about delta is unital? So delta tilde id of x, y is equal to g inverse x, y, id of x tensor y, g, x, y, but id which is, because this is identity, you can just remove, you can just forget that. And so what you get is id of x tensor id y, which is because id is a, the functor, id is a functor, is a tensor, it's a tensor functor, but we don't need that. Anyway, so okay, etc., etc. So etc. See the book on page 12 for coalgebra structure. And on page 92 for more details for the proof. In fact, there is not so much detail in the book also, but maybe a bit more than some other details. They did not write that in the book. But they write something else. But anyway, so it's just a question of checking axiom, and it's more or less easy. Okay, so now, okay, so now we have the structure of bi-algebra. If it is if it's, you have the co-multiplication and co-unique satisfying all the previous property, you have a bi-algebra. So definition, an algebra H equipped with delta co-multiplication and co-unique delta and epsilon satisfying above 1, 2, 1, 2. There is called a bi-algebra. Bi-algebra. In fact, I want to mention here that so. We will, from category theory, tensor or ring category theory, we will recover, we can reconstruct bi-algebra of algebra. And in fact, the point of view of this book is to do everything in terms of category. In particular, we will see in this book that some result coming from of algebra can be reproved in the categorical framework and sometimes reproved in a much easier way. That's a big advantage of category framework. You have a larger view. So I have a biAlgebra. And what about homomorphism of biAlgebra? Homomorphism of biAlgebra. Is a unit algebra homomorphism between biAlgebra, which preserve the multiplication co-unit in the sense I will explain. So a homomorphism of biAlgebra. So H delta epsilon H prime delta prime prime. Homomorphism phi by algebra like that is is a unital algebra homomorphism, the unital algebra homomorphism. So homomorphism of unital algebra so between biAlgebra which preserve co-multiplication and co-unit. And co-unit, and I guess that this means the following: delta prime phi of A, or delta tensor delta phi tensor phi of delta A, and epsilon prime phi of A is phi of A. I guess this is what they mean by preserve the co-multiplication and co-unit. It's quite natural. So conclusion, what time is it? So by Abbot theorem, the algebra of natural transformation between the fiber function itself is a biAlgebra. Conclusion. By Abbot theorem, H equal end of F as a natural structure of biAlgebra. Now, the question is the converse. You start from a biAlgebra, and can you get a ring category? In fact, you can get, this is a ring category of representation of this biAlgebra. The monoidal category. In fact, there is a small gap. I don't know if we can call that a gap, because to define a fiber functor, you need a ring category. But then, for the representation category of a biAlgebra, they said that it's monoidal category. So I guess it's maybe an exercise to prove it's a ring category, or you may restrict to buy algebra for which your representation category is a ring category. I don't know. So conversely, let H be any. So I restrict to the finite, the finite dimensional case. In the book, they mention something which they also mention the case where it is not finite dimensional, but I skip that. Finite dimensional by algebra. The category rep H of finite dimensional representation, another word, left module of H is a monoidal category. And as I said, exercise, it is a finite ring category. I put a question mark because I don't know whether it's an exercise, whether we should show that or whether we should assume that. So one can we can define the tensor product between two H modules as follow. So we can define the tensor product of two. In fact, you define the tensor product exactly as for vector space, but then what we need to know is how the bi-algebra act on this tensor product of vector space. So you can define the tensor product of two H module or representation if you prefer as the usual tensor product on vector space. And the point is to know what is the action. So where the action of H is given as follow by so the action on X tensor Y of an element of the algebra H. So what is in other words, what is the matrix? This is given by you have the action, you make the tensor product of the action. And you apply it to the co-multiplication of A. Here, A is an element of H. Where the action from the is defined as the phi rho x from H to the matrix algebra. And the same for if you have Y, you have Y. And this is a matrix. You can see it. Matrix algebra. Okay. So now we define. So you have the representation You have a category, you have the tensor product. Now we need, you need to define, you need to prove the, we need to show the axiom of a monoidal category. And then maybe as an exercise, or maybe as an assumption, the for a ring category. But what about monoidal category first? So the associativity, associativity isomorphism are just the obvious one from VEC. And the unit, the unit is will be the one-dimensional vector space given by the field in which H act using and the action of H on this one-dimensional vector space is given by the co-unit. So the unit is just K on which H act by multiplication via co-unit A maps to epsilon A. So co-unit. So what is the action on that? This is from K to the field, where an element you associate phi A of X. This is the action. Okay, so it's by multiplication in that sense here. And finally, the forgetful functor. Forgetful functor rep H to vec. So forget. Forgetful functor. In the book, they call it forget. That's why I write forget is a fiber functor. Fiber functor. Again, you can, maybe it's an exercise also. Maybe easy. So then we get what we were interested in this chapter. We get the reconstruction theorem. So it's just a summary of what we discuss from the beginning. We will have a reconstruction theorem for bialgebra and a reconstruction theorem for of algebra. Here for bialgebra, and it's about ring category, and for of algebra we will have tensor category, more precisely finite ring and finite tensor category. So so the assignment, we have two finite ring category fiber functor. Go to the category of representation, monoidal category of representation, or you start from a bialgebra and you consider No, not the category of representation here, the category, the algebra, sorry, the bi-algebra of made by the natural transformation between the Fourier functor and itself. This is the first assignment. And the second assignment, you start from a bi-algebra, and you get the category, this category, and the forgetful functor. So these assignments are mutually inverse bijection. Inverse bijection between finite ring category C with fiber functor F C to VEC, so up to everything is up to equivalence, up to tensor equivalence and isomorphism of tensor functor to equivalence, and the isomorphism class so not R but provide, I guess, provide so isomorphism class of finite dimensional bi-algebra over the field K. Isomorphism classes of finite dimensional bi-algebra. H over the field K. So this this reconstruction theorem is very conceptually deep. In fact, and this is not the we will state some other reconstruction theorem like that later. It's conceptually deep because you have an equivalence between something in category and something in algebra world. So every finite ring category can be seen as a representation category of bi-algebra. And more precisely, you have an equivalence if you choose a fiber functor on the finite ring category, then this is exactly the bi-algebra up to equivalence. So that's very, very important, very deep. Okay. So there is a way to make this reconstruction theorem to make a categorical version of this reconstruction theorem. In fact, you have an equivalence between two categories. Just for fun, you can write that. So the categorical version of Abaff theorem and in the book, it is stated as stronger than Abaff theorem. So the functor rep from between these two categories we will define just now, FBH and F, R, C, F. H, 2, rep, H. Is an equivalence where so FBI F by ALGE is a category of finite, so as you can expect, finite dimensional biAlgebra by algebra over K with where the morphism are isomorphism. And FRCF is a category of finite ring, a category of category, finite ring category with fiber functor. So you have an equivalence of category like that. Okay. So it's almost time. What can we do before the end? It remains 7 minutes. Okay, so remark about you can have a biAlgebra, but you can also define the dual of a biAlgebra. So I don't go into the detail. You should refer to maybe the book on page 12 or later. So let H be a finite dimensional biAlgebra. So not in parentheses, in fact. Finite dimensional biAlgebra. BiAlgebra. Then write respectively left module over H correspond to the left respectively right module or co-module over the dual biAlgebra H star. So write respectively left module over H correspond to left respectively right co-module over H, the dual of H, the dual biAlgebra of H. So you have right, left module, you have the algebra and the biAlgebra H and its dual. You can go from one to the other. So right H module correspond to left H star co-module, etc., etc. Okay. So what I will mention finally, so you have the category of H module, also called the category of representation of a biAlgebra H, but we will need to consider maybe later the category of H co-module. And for that, you need to understand what do you mean by tensor product of coaction. So if X, Y are right, say right H comodule. So, we will define the coaction, the tensor product of the, what is the coaction on the tensor product? Coaction, we will see what is the coaction on the tensor product H tensor point. So first, what? So again, you should go to the book page 12 or around page 12 to see more details about what is a coaction, what is a coalgebra, etc. So for x in x, y in y, you have the coaction like that. So this is a coaction, and this coaction like that. And what will be the coaction on the tensor product? Then the right co-module X tensor Y is the usual one on VEC, vector space from VEC. With coaction as follow, pi x tensor y of x tensor y is sum over I of x I tensor y I tensor a I e I. So as I said, see book page 12 for definition of coaction, etc. So for the last minute, notation. So for the category of H module, rep H, and the category of H comodule will be denoted H comod. Just a notation we will use later for bialgebra H, the monoidal category of finite dimensional H comodule is denoted H comod. Okay, that's okay for today. So next, see you next time. We will start with top algebra and reconstruction theorem. Okay. So, bye bye.